the best WWE figures of 2018 so far. Good morning, my wrestling heroes. It is almost mid-year, and it is time that we gather up some of the greats. Now, this video right here, it will be mainly focused on elites. If you guys want to see one with basics, drop it in the comment section. I'm sure we can get around to doing that. Now, right here, it wouldn't be a glorious video without the man himself, Bobby Roode. This was part of the NXT TakeOver line, Series 2. There were a lot of other great figures in the set. I think one of them was Rusev, Roman Reigns. The third one was Ember Moon. But this one right here, this one was the hardest one to find. As a matter of fact, I only found him once. I found him once in the wild, never again. When he first was found, man, people were paying crazy amount of dollars. I think he was going for $150 on eBay. And, you know, it makes sense. This was the very first time that they had introduced this NXT title. This is the updated NXT title. We did get one in the past, but this was basically the one that we're seeing on TV nowadays. This belt was straight fire. And I think this one right here, I don't know if this is the reason why this figure makes it on the list. I mean, the figure was great. This was our very first elite that we had actually got. We got a basic prior to this, and they did actually end up reusing the same scan on the elite. There is a recent basic that they've put out, and it is a different scan. Most likely, if we end up doing the basics, that one will most likely fall in that category. Now, this right here, I can't necessarily go over the figure itself from the knees down, because I did do some updates, did some fix-ups, got some current long-style knee pads with the white boots, but the figure itself, it was great. I mean, it was very bland. Really, the only thing that this figure was missing, at least for me, it was that entrance rope, but we did eventually get it in the entrance greats line, and you'll most likely see that one later on in the video. Now, right here, the Hardy Boys, I'm going to automatically put these into one. I mean, this was a dual pack. This was the epic moments. And this is just an early prediction. There are going to be other epic moments figures put out later on in the year, but I think for these right here, these are going to be it. This is going to be the epic moments of the year. We got so much with these Hardys. We got four ladders. We got two tall, two small. We got the SmackDown. Was it the first time that we had gotten this? I'm pretty sure. Yeah, this was the first time that, and then it was like later put on with Elite Series 57 and 58. But yes, it was the red strap belts, and these a lot of people wanted. I mean, these were put out at least well over a year prior to them actually putting them in figure form. Jeff Hardy, I do love this figure. This one, actually, I love just about every Jeff Hardy that they put out so far. The only bad thing was, and I know a lot of people have had this issue with, you can kind of see the tank top seeping through. I mean, apart from that, the scan is just, it's fire. I love both, actually both of them, especially Matt Hardy. He's like, yes, I am in the top figures of 2018. Again, it is mid-year, and we'll most likely, some of these might get replaced once we do like the end of 2018. But this one right here, this one was so cool. I think they really just went all out with the attire. Really cool. Cool figures. Now, we have gotten this recent SummerSlam Elite Wave, and I'm gonna have to say that just about every figure in this line, it's gonna make the list. Rollins right here, this is the red attire. This is using the face print. Again, I know a lot of people have stressed about them not liking the face print, but again, it does work on some. I think it definitely works on Rollins. We're getting his entrance jacket. We're getting the Raw Tag Team title. It looks like they just kept putting it out. As soon as they got their hands on them being able to put out those tag team titles, they just kept pumping them out. Now, Matt Hardy, again, like I said, a lot of these figures are gonna be from the SummerSlam Wave. They're gonna be in this video, there's no doubt. This was an introduction to a lot of new stuff. We got the interchangeable hands, and we did get something earlier on in the year with like interchangeable arms, which again, we'll get into a little bit later on in the video, but this was cool. And I mean, I know a lot of people have been asking, if you guys didn't see the review on this, it is really easy for these to pop in and out. I think they might have used like the same style as with the Marvel Legends with the design of it to, it stays in there real good and they pop out really smooth. Plus you got two shirts with this and it was version one. I mean, oh man, I can't tell you how many people were worried because the first time that they showed that figure, they weren't showing it with like, you know, him wearing that shirt. It was the warning shirt. Now, Kevin Owens, this is part of the WrestleMania wave. For me, I was a big fan of this. It does have that retro look for the shirt style. It's got KO2 Mania. And we had gotten the US title. I mean, prior to this, it was a while since we had gotten this. So it was definitely nice to get a KO in the collection. Plus, like I said, an updated US title. Now, the probability of all these figures standing, I know we talk about this a lot, but yeah, they're all gonna eventually fall. I'm sure Super Cena will eventually come in here and bury them. Now, Cena, they put out a lot of Cenas. There is no doubt that Mattel pumps these guys out like crazy, especially in the basic line. This one right here, this one I loved so much. The reason why, this was such an important moment in John Cena's history. This is when he took on Michaels at WrestleMania. The camo, this camo attire, it is fire, man. Like the hat, like the shirt, everything about this Cena, it was awesome. Actually, the whole line itself. Now, Edge, again, another SummerSlam Elite. This is from the one that came with Rollins and Matt Hardy. This is also using the one with the face print. And again, the only thing, I mean, most likely this figure would have probably been ranked in the top five, maybe even the top three. Had they just include this? Come on, man. What's going on? Oh, had they given us a soft cloth jacket, I definitely see this figure ranking high. They haven't yet for Edge. They have for Matt. So that's the kind of confusing part about it all. And again, with the face print, oh yeah, definitely a solid 9, maybe even 10. I like this one a lot. I think they just, oh dude, I don't know. It's, you know, it does it for some, it doesn't do it for others. This Balor, I think it does it for just about everyone. Well, except the torso, right? See, with every Finn Balor that they're putting out, whether it's, you know, in the past or in the upcoming near future here, they go crazy with it. I mean, the detail that it takes to make a Finn Balor attire, and that's the reason why, I know a lot of people wonder why they just give us the Daniel Bryan. To my understanding, at least from what Bill from Mattel had said, that anytime they do like this much detail on a figure, it is really hard to do the print on a Cody Rhodes torso. So I think this is the route, this is the reason why they take this route. Like, the only time that they'll normally, you know, add it to like a Cody Rhodes torso is it if like if it's an exclusive or if it's like an entrance greats. Now this right here, this was a Walgreens exclusive. You most likely saw this one on the channel as of fairly recent. This one was just found, and I was shocked because, I mean, anything prior to this, Becky Lynch, Sasha Banks, I found Becky once also, never again. So the fact that I had found her, and she is pretty rare, the way that they're putting her out, it is just, it's nuts. So they're only putting out one per store, doesn't make sense. I mean, like, do they only think they're only going to sell one? Honestly, I think they're going to sell a lot more. I think if they actually put out at least 5 per store, 4, I definitely do see these this one selling out pretty well, or selling pretty well. It's just, I don't know, the attire for me, this is one of my favorite women's figures in my current roster. I think she's the one that's gonna knock everybody out. I'm gonna put her in the back because I'm telling you, if I put her in the front, she is that domino effect that's just waiting to happen. Now, Big Show, this is the one from the entrance, no, Fan Central, the Toys R Us exclusive. This Fan Central, this is the very last Fan Central Elite that we'll get. We'll take that back. They are going to eventually transfer it to a different store. But what I'm saying, this is going to be the last Elite that Toys R Us will be putting out. They've stopped production of all the Elites or just about any figure that's going to be put out. I think all the trucks have actually delivered. That's one thing I wanted to post you or keep you guys updated on. Every figure that they've put out as of yet. So what's happening is that whatever you're seeing on the shelves right now at Toys R Us, that's it. It's a sad story, but this figure, this brightens up the day. There's no doubt. I mean, again, we got the updated torso with him. We got that massive beard game. Big Show, we're going to put you in back, man. We got it. Because if we keep you up front, I feel like you're going to be choke slamming some people. I'm curious. We're going to play the guessing game. Which figure in this video is going to knock down all these guys? Now, Shinsuke Nakamura, this was from Elite Series 57? 58? 57. We've gotten, you know, a couple of them in the past. We got the very first entrance greats last year, and we also got the NXT TakeOver. I'm a fan of this one, and we have to include this in the list. One, it's because it's the man, right? It's the strong style Shinsuke Nakamura. It's the cloth shirt. It's the red attire with added designs, because anything that we've gotten for the Elites, they didn't have, like, the studded pattern design. And mine actually stands. I know this is one thing that I had stressed in the figure review. Look at this. He actually stands. I couldn't get any of my other Nakamuras prior to this figure to get to stand. Now, these two, again, we're going to have to do them in a dual pack. And I did do some fix-ups on these ones. These are the WWE Shop exclusive Hardy Boys. I mean, really, the only fix-up is that I added the shirt from the entrance greats. Yes, the entrance greats. And I also added the shirt from the old Elite Matt Hardy that we had gotten in the past. So I'll take these off so you guys can get a better understanding. And the hat. I also swapped out the scan. I wasn't a fan of the one that they gave us with this one, so I put the one with the hair down. And he has worn it like that. That's why I had those shirts on him. But yes, these are actually the only Hardy Boys, you know, like flashback styles that we've gotten so far. I hope that we get like Team Extreme. I think that's the one that, if you were to ask Hardy Boy fans, you know, whether it's Jeff or Matt, those are the ones that we definitely want. Now right here, I did do a swap on her. After seeing her, and she still has to fall in this category regardless of the size of the scan. I mean, this is from her old basic. The attire, man, look at this. This is Disco Inferno at its best. Where'd she go? Like back to the 70s? I don't know. I think the blue right here, this is definitely one of my favorites. What was it? Elite Series 58? 57? It's so hard, man. I'm telling you. To remember all these waves. Now I'm going to do the rest of these right here together. We got to do them in a set. We got to do, let's see. It was him. We already got KO. We already got Cena. We'll do these two. I think this WrestleMania wave right here, WrestleMania 34 line, they did a great job. Randy Orton, after a while, I did find out that he did have some imperfections, but it was mainly the scan for me for Orton right here, as well as the vest. I mean, he didn't wear it with the actual attire, but I this is actually one vest that I wanted in figure form. And right here, Brutus the Barber Beefcake, this was giving us hope that we are going to get that. I mean, if he does eventually re-sign, right, Hulk Hogan, we'll get the Mega Maniacs, and we can definitely display these together. I mean, plus, I mean, all these accessories, right? We got the scissors right here that actually articulate. We got the removable mask right here that comes right off, and it's just really bright. It's just a really bright attire. It definitely has to fall on the list. Man, I am shocked that they are all still standing. Now, right here, this is also part of the Fan Central line. This is the one that was with Big Show, Mark Henry, and Bobby the Brain Heenan. This is early Triple H. We do need one for like 1998, 1999, but this is one of the closest things that we'll get for that. This is when he won the World Heavyweight title. He took on Big Papa Pump, Scott Steiner, in that match. Really love that Triple H. I might actually do a custom with that. I picked up a second one, so I think I might finally satisfy that need of making that Attitude Era, like late 1998-99 Triple H. Now, right here, this actually, again, another one that hasn't been put out. I had to order this one off eBay from from Canada. There was a seller on eBay that was selling these. Because, again, this is another figure that the only way you were going to get this. Man, this is just a sad part about a lot of these figures for the Toys R Us exclusives. A lot of these you weren't able to get unless if A, you lived in Canada, or B, you paid up the markup on eBay. Now, this is the one that I was talking about earlier in the video with the interchangeable parts. So we had gotten the interchangeable hands with Matt Hardy, but this year they had introduced, well, I guess you could almost say it in the past, because just about any Build-A-Figure or Collect and Connect figure that we've gotten in the sets, you could just easily pop them off and pop them back on. But this one was truly designed for you to interchange it. So this one came with a red vest, so you could interchange the hands, so actually the complete vest of it all. And it's Bobby the Brain Heenan. Oh my gosh, I can't believe I called. I'm thinking about that Heenan. I'm thinking about that Fan Central line way too much. So it was nice that we got Mean Gene Oakland. You know, this guy is one of the best. When it comes to like the best interviewer, it was almost Mean Gene that knocked everybody down. I am impressed that all these have still remained standing. Now, couldn't have one of the best figures of 2018 without Latino Heat. This was part of the WWE Hall of Champions, and this series was the very first introduction to the wave, or to the line, because prior to this was WWE Hall of Fame Elites. And this was great. This was a great way to get it started with Eddie Guerrero. This is from his WCW days. Really love this Eddie. Can't tell you how happy I was that we had gotten this one. The only thing that figure was missing was the updated WCW title, which they could have definitely, you know, included with that, because they actually do own the rights. It was just mainly because of cost issues. Now, right here, Amber Moon, also another figure. So it looks like there's two, maybe even three figures from this line, from this NXT TakeOver line, Bobby Roode being the other one right here. This one actually, so the way that had worked out, when I had found this one, this was the only one that I had found, and then, like, you know, a couple days later, I eventually found the rest from the set. I love this Amber Moon. I think that they just, everything about this figure, I really am enjoying. I mean, they've just done so much with this to make sure that they'd gotten everything on it, like the entrance vest, that bandana around her mouth, like the hair. Like, it's crazy how they blended it in right there, and those eyes. I have stressed way too much about these eyes. I ain't gonna bore you to death, but it's kind of hard to with these eyes, man. Oh, she's standing. Yes, she never stands for me. I am shocked. Now, Rollins, Seth freaking Rollins. This man, if you were to ask any person, like, what character in WWE has the most creative attires? Apart from Rollins, it's got to be Seth freaking Rollins. And I think that's why he does so well anytime that they put him out. I mean, these figures, they don't last long. You put them on the shelf on a Friday, they ain't coming back on Saturday morning. This one was from the WrestleMania when he took on Triple H, Kingslayer. Really, really dig how they actually added, like, the sculpt work for the feathers right there on the sides. I thought they were just going to paint it on. They did with the kick pads, but with the actual tight design, they didn't. And the accessory, man, we've never gotten this in the past. This is like a flame torch. So what he had done when he had come out, he put it on the entrance stage and everything just lit, man. I mean, this figure, it is lit. This Rollins, I'm shocked that it's not falling in the top five. And none of these are ranked by any means. I want you guys to know that right now. Towards the end of the video, I am definitely ranking like the top three, top four. Now, Matt Hardy, again, another Hardy Boys. I think just about every Hardy figure in this, like, that they put out for 2018 might be in this. This is from Elite Series 58. Really like the green. They gave us a new scan from that, what was it, the Epic Moments? And I thought they were just going to reuse it, but no, it's crazy, because, I mean, it's like, these ones were putting out, like, back-to-back. Now, right here, this is a Zack Ryder, and, okay, here's the thing about Zack Ryder. All right, I know a lot of people are not a fan of this entrance jacket. The thing that I really like about this Ryder is, A, we haven't gotten an Elite in quite some time, and B, this is a combination of a lot of different legends. Some of the best. Macho Man, Ultimate Warrior, Sting, you name it. This man included this into his attire. And me being, you know, a retro, or, you know, I like both. I like modern and I like also my retro superstars. But this was cool. This was like the best of both worlds, I feel like. I think this one, they just went crazy with it. I mean, the head did sit a little bit low. But apart from that, it was a great figure. Now, right here, here is the entrance. Right here is the other glorious man right here, Bobby Roode. And I think this man's going to have to go on the back. We're all getting bombarded here, man. We're going to have to back you guys up some. Bobby Roode right here. This is part of the entrance greats line. This is the third, or was it the fourth? Someone drop it in the comment section, because it was, I know it was, what was it? It was Kurt Angle, Jeff Hardy, I believe he was the third one. There might be one, I'm drawing a blank, but I feel like he was the third one introduced when they reintroduced the entrance greats line right here. This is cool. This is what the first Elite was missing, was this entrance robe. On this one, again, the same scan, but the difference between the first NXT TakeOver Elite and this one is that, again, with this one, and I feel like it's going to happen a lot more here in the future, is the face print. This is the one that's mainly where the differences that you're noticing, and the attire too. You're getting the purple attire, but this entrance robe, man, this was like one of the main reasons why I wanted this figure. And I'm sure it's different for some, but definitely, and I told you, it was going to be here. That's why I put her in the way back. All right, so it looks like a couple of them have fallen down. Wow, I am still impressed that all these guys are still standing. Bobby the Brain Heenan. See, when you say Bobby, this is kind of what I think of. I mean, we got the one in the four pack, right, with the four horsemen. Was it the four horsemen? No, it wasn't the four horsemen. Sorry. It's the one that came with Andre the Giant, and there was two other figures in the set. But this right here, I wanted this one because this is kind of what you mainly remember Bobby the Brain Heenan by. It wasn't that, like, bright white suit that he wore. It was mainly this. He had worn this in WCW as well as WWF. So that's one of the reasons why this figure. And, you know, if you end up picking him up, I mean, if you don't actually end up using him for Bobby the Brain Heenan, you are getting some nice black pants. You can make some really good customs out of this or throw the man in the crowd. Either or, this man will definitely do it for you. Now, right here, this is actually, come to think of it, and I could be wrong, but this is the only Undertaker Elite that we've gotten, like, this year, which is crazy, because, I mean, if you think in the past, they would release, like, two, three, like, they would, Undertaker's a very popular figure that always does well in the market, so the fact that this is the only Elite, this is from the WWE Hall of Champions, also a Target exclusive. This is the better, I think, at least for me, this is definitely, again, and this is all based on personal preference. I'm sure there's figures in here that might not be in the video, but this right here, when you say, like, Ministry of Darkness, I think, at least for the scan, this is definitely, I prefer this one, the head scan on this one, versus the one that we got with the SDCC. Now, right here, we have six, also known as X-Pac, and I know you're going to be like, dude, this is the exact same thing as the very first X-Pac. It kind of is. I mean, it is just a repaint on the attire is what it mainly is. It is the same scan as well. Exact same scan, but when you say NWO, when you say New World Order, technically you can't have that without the sixth member, right? So again, for me, that's one of the reasons why it's so important. Now, Batista, the Animal, also another figure from the WWE Hall of Champions. He didn't come with this belt. I just included him in there, or that belt, because that's how I had it displayed with the Evolution. But the Red Man, this is wicked. This red attire on Batista, this is actually one of my favorite Batistas that they've put out. I think all in all, they've maybe done 6? Drop it in the comment section. They've done quite a few Batistas, but this early Batista for me, the animal, like, this is from those days, from those good days when they were that evolution, right? Evolution is a mystery. Now, this next two, I gotta do them together. I have to. I mean, again, these were in a set. These were actually the very first epic moments. I think they, the crazy thing was for me was that the fact that they had recreated this in figure form, like out of any moment in history, this was the moment that they decided to choose with to introduce the line. And you got so much. That's the one thing I love about these entrance crates is that they just give you so much. Like, it's crazy. They go crazy with the accessories. I only, you know, in the video, I mean, for, you know, for video purposes, like I just added the belts, right? The US title and the universal as well as the list. You can't have this video without the list of Jericho, but no, bro, it's KO. Now, next up, the world's strongest man, Sexual Chocolate, Mark Henry, whatever you want to call this guy. This, okay, two reasons why. A, I wanted him, you know, for this attire, and B, if you guys didn't see the video, go on the channel. We did get a recent custom of this from Nation of Domination. This is the best fodder parts for that. Love this Mark Henry. This is... Oh man, now we need a Mae Young. I think that's what we actually need to actually complete. Again, some of these figures aren't going to be able to be placed on the display because it's crazy. It is crazy. Like, and it, look at this. Look at this madness. How are all these guys still standing? And believe it or not, we are down to the final four, which is crazy, right? Now, this next one right here, this is from Elite Series 47? 48? 47. 57. Sorry, 57. Reborn by Fate. And if for some reason I botch it on any of these, I'll try to edit it and put it into the video if for some reason I got the Elite Series wrong. Because if it's one thing you gotta know about Hero Figs, if you are still 21 minutes in the video, we botch a lot on this video. And that's alright, because you guys are still the best, right? Now, Jeff Hardy, I love this one. This is the one that came with the shirtless. Again, I mean, you did get the shirt, but there was the option right here to have him shirtless. And this is what you mainly see Jeff Hardy, whether it's like Attitude Era, whether it's Ruthless Aggression, whether it's Modern Era, this is what you mainly, when you say Jeff Hardy, it usually happens at the end of every single match. So getting him shirtless right there, man, plus all the details on the tattoo, come on, you can't go wrong with this Jeff Hardy. Now, this next one right here, it's crazy. I actually didn't think that this one was even going to be worth the pickup. This Braun Strowman, Braun! This one is definitely on the list. And it, again, for me, it was almost a pass because the attire, it was very similar to the one that we had gotten prior to this. But what they did is that with this one, they actually went out of their way to do the sculpting on the actual pants. And this scan, man, this scan might be the scan of 2018. I think once we actually revisit this video at the end of this year, this one, oh man, I love this man. Oh, I can't tell you how much use I've gotten out of this figure because of that head scan. Now, next up, and I know you're saying, dude, how can you possibly not include, how can this not be number one? It is crazy to think that, believe it or not, because this figure, this was the figure that everyone wanted. But I'm going to tell you this, and this is the reason why. And I know we've gone over this figure a lot, but this is the reason why. So he's clearly number two, right, in my list. Number one, and I'm still, I don't know. Mattel's going to really have to step up their game to overcome number one for me. Number one, this Kurt Angle. This was the Kurt Angle that I had wanted. Like, when they told, when Mattel had said, we're going to be making Kurt Angle figures in the Mattel line, I was freaking out. First thing that came to mind was this, from this era right here. This is when he took on Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania. Like, apart from this entrance jacket, man, like, I almost wanted to pick up a couple of more so we could make some custom Team Angle, Shelton Benjamin and Chad Gable. But this attire was fire, dude. This blue, I love the blue. This has a combination of my two favorite colors, red as well as blue. I think they did a really great job. And the scan, brand new scan on this. This was not a reused one. I thought they were just gonna reuse the one that we had gotten with his GM attire, but no, they got something completely new on this. Love the scan, love the overall figure. This was ranked extremely high. If you guys didn't see the review on this, we ranked this through the Richter scale, man. We're gonna have to do a new scale, man. It's gonna have to be like Hero Figs approved or something. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Again, if for some reason your figures didn't make it on the channel, drop it in the comment section. Would definitely love to hear your top five for 2018 so far. Until next time, everybody.